So welcome to another photobook critique. This time we have an interesting member. It is Watanabe Rika, who is actually the first member in Keyakizaka 46 to get a photobook. Now, as a model herself already, being in the same magazine as Shiraishi Mai from Nogizaka, I have a lot to expect from this, but at the same time, I don't expect a lot. So the reason why I expect a lot is because she's actually a magazine model for Ray. And the reason I don't expect a lot is because they're fairly fresh members. They don't have a whole bunch of experience with this. And Watanabe Rika is not the most expressive person in Keyakizaka 46. So I have my expectations and no expectations. So really, I'm at a real neutral right now. If Ray saw potential in this girl, then that's what's really motivating me to actually see what she can do in here. But then again, seeing on other TV shows, she isn't like the most expressive person, you know, especially in front of the cameras. So now we shall see what exactly goes through with this photo book. But first, I want to talk about who the photographer is. The photographer is Chizuru Abe, who actually hasn't done any 48 or 46 photo books before. This photographer has done 5 other photo books and has actually worked on different magazines like Nylon, Ray, Cam Cam, a whole bunch of different magazines. So if they are able to work with those people, then I imagine a photo book would turn out good. So now I will actually look at the photo book and analyze all the pictures and be able to spit out some information for you guys. And at the end of this video, you can see who I recommend this to and whether it was worth the purchase. Alright, so I looked through it, and the weirdest thing about this is that I had a hard time picking my favorite photo. And that's not because there were a lot of ones that I saw were my favorite, it's that a lot of them seem to kind of blend in with each other. And that's not with scenario or with the location. It might be her expression that kind of is similar throughout. It kind of felt like default positions that they're confident with. But I did have to decide between two at the end, so that is a good sign. Again, deciding if one was my favorite or not was harder in this one than it has been in other ones. And that could be taken as a good thing or as a bad thing. But enough about that, let's talk about the book a little bit more. And as we can see, it's actually really big. It's like almost two of my hands. For reference, let's take Ikuta Erika's photo book, which all of you should pick up. It's really good. It's exactly the same size as this, so it is like one of the bigger ones. The only one a little bit bigger than this one is actually Akimoto Manatsu's, which is the biggest one I have. It's like a little bit longer, so it's not that much bigger. And this is the photo that I got on the side. This is actually a really cool photo. I wish this one was in the photo book. This one would have been one of my favorites. So it's actually really good that I got it like this. It's like a little like postcard. Now looking at this cover, if I could pick one word that describes it, it's hopeful. So holding a ticket in the hand, kind of giving like a wishful look, it's kind of hopeful, like hopefully my journey goes good. Hopefully this photo book is good. So in that, being the first person in Keyakizaka and being her first photo book, I can see how this expression is really well suited for this photo book. And looking at the back, we get a little bit more expressive, a little bit more about her and removing all the distractions, which we see sometimes in this photo book and sometimes we see a little bit too much distractions. This is a nice simple one right here. There's a lot of arm right here, but that doesn't bother me too much. And looking on the inside, we see it's all white, and I don't know if that's better or worse than Hori Miyona's, which was just the front cover and back cover, but in black and white. I feel like this one is a little bit more conscious decision, like we can't just make it black and white. Help make it a little bit less noticeable that it's actually a photo book. Make it more, I don't know, does it say on the side? It says it on the side. So maybe make it a little bit more fancier, maybe not having like this face in the front and this face in the back, but just having a nice pure white, kind of giving off like an empty canvas, like Watanabe Rika's an empty canvas because she's an aspiring model and magazine covers have got a... So let's go on to the first picture. First picture is actually very small. I don't know what the creative decision was behind this, but we do see this quite a bit And I think it works negatively when you have so many of them. Not like this exactly, but other variations of it. It shows some intention, but doing it so repeatedly, you get used to it. And you always want to start off with a really strong image or an introductory image. And this one doesn't really say either. It is a little bit cool, but if it was bigger, I think it would give a lasting impression. Meanwhile, we move to this big old one, which is actually spanning the whole two pages. And this is a little bit more about the location and her in it, which is always great to see in location photo books. And as we know, she's in a very popular place. You might have seen this place before. And if you don't know where it is, it's actually in Greece. This is actually a very famous spot to take pictures. Like, I think over here, they usually take pictures and take a picture of this whole place, and it looks really nice. But here we see her here at this very nice place, and her wearing all white actually goes really well with the white buildings, so props. And then we go to this picture, which actually is kind of bad because over here it's all super blown out, but that's thanks to her in the shadow. Actually, ignoring all of this, it's actually a fairly nice picture. Like, if it was just this page, it's fairly nice. Although, that's what you would think. If you look at these pinks right here, it's a little bit too pink. It's so pink that they're actually blending in with each other. The pink doesn't have that much variation in it. That's how pink it is. And I don't know if this was increased, like the greens were increased and the pinks were increased, but the pinks are a little bit too strong and it's making everything look blended in together and mushy. Although the lighting is really nice on her face. And the expression is not the greatest though. So negatives and positives. Then move on to a variation of the back cover, and I actually like this one more because the arm isn't as distracting in this image and it looks a little more cutesy, which is more Watanabe Rika like. And I really like how sharp this is, and it even looks like they added a little bit of sharpness in post-production too. And this is where we start into the photo book for real. This one I actually really like. I like the long slender bend of the body, and adding this bend right here actually extends it even more, kind of warping it in a little. So in your mind you're thinking, okay, it goes in a little, so it makes your imagination think, okay, she must be like really long and really stretched out. And plus the arm and everything stretching out and the toe stretching out and everything, it just all blends in together and makes her look really long. Although there's not a lot of shape because the bend's right here, you can still tell a difference because it's like right here and at the bend it's right here, so it does do something still. And plus the lighting is nice in this one because of the big window over here and the room's all white, so it's all reflecting towards her. And plus I like little Aoko right there. Now this one's a little interesting because I actually really like this one, and that's because it kind of looks like it was shot in a studio, but it kind of looks like it was at the windowsill because of the light that's wrapping around her hair. And although the hands aren't in my favorite position, I still like this photo because of the expression she has on her face. This is like, she does like little slight variations on her regular expressions, and I feel like it adds a lot, so that is potential for her to be a model. And as soon as she comes out of her shell, I feel like she could really go out and prosper. Now here's something we see here that is actually a theme throughout the photo book, and it's this right here. There's two things. Number one, it's a little slanted, which I see sometimes in some of these photos. And number two, there's people in the background. As this is a very touristy place, there will be a lot of people, and sometimes it does distract from the image. I'll show you more examples later on, but be aware of this when you're looking through it. As we see in this example, there are people there, but they're blurred out thanks to what looks like, this one's probably like a 50 millimeter, is my guess. It looks like it's a little bit more warped over here. So I'm guessing like a 50, like what I have right now. But the people in the back blurred out in that bokeh, so it isn't that distracting. And plus I actually like that this is like all about her. Although this line right here is crossing through her and these lines right here are crossing through her head. A little distracting, but nothing too bad. Ooh, I want to say the lighting on this one is actually very, very nice. I think there was a change of lens between these two, it's a guess. But this one I actually like a lot because of the light that's actually happening. And this is thanks to her sitting somewhere and there being a window like right behind the photographer. Because if you look in the eyes, you can actually see the photographer and the window. And plus that creamy bokeh in the background, super nice. I'm guessing like an 85 on this one. These two images, which are the same thing back and forth, there's a better way of doing this, which we'll see later on. But in this case, I would have much rather seen this one. This one has a much better expression, which I don't really see on Watanabe Rika. So Just seeing this one alone would have made it worth it. And plus, the lighting isn't too bad with it being super sunny. Now we move on to where the problems start a little bit. And as you can see, all of this white space, I mean, you shove the picture all the way up and there could have been space for another picture. I mean, if you do something like this, then you could easily put another picture right here. And I'm not too big of a fan of this one right here. I feel like other people have done it better in their photo books. Her expression just isn't saying too much in this one. Although in this one, it is saying more. And that's thanks to that window giving more shape to the face, adding a little bit more drama with the shadows. It's all about photographer-model collaboration. Next, we have Taurus City over here. I'm glad that she wore the red, because without the red, she would not be able to stick out. So that was a great decision on whoever made it. Because as we've seen, no one's wearing this bright of a red. And I imagine it's a little bit vibrancy just going up a little bit on her. And after all the images of the Colosseum, we actually move on to these cat pictures right here. And I have to say, if they would have just included this last one right here, then I would have been totally satisfied. Having all this white space right here, again, not my most favorite thing ever. But the reason why I like this last picture is because she's going like this, cat's going like this, and they're both looking towards the camera. It's actually a very nice, like, split in the middle. They're both doing the same thing, but on opposite sides, kind of mirroring each other. And that's actually very, very nice. And I wish this was bigger so it could be shown out more. Other than, like, her playing with the cats. Even though it's cute, I feel like this is a super strong image. It could have stood by itself. Next up, get ready for more distractions with this one. As you can see, oh look, it's just her standing at the pool, right? With the cruise ship behind her, you know, everything's white and blue. She's wearing blue. And then bam, we have someone right there distracting everything. It's like her, she's right here, but then like you lead towards the whites right here and then kind of goes towards her. And then you just like see her and you're just like, oh, there's another person there. And then you kind of lose your attention from this a little bit. Like, I mean, of course she's the main subject of the photo, but seeing her right here with the white line leading towards her and leaning towards her kind of like do the opposite effect of drawing the attention towards her. Oh, look at this one, you know, just a regular picture, you know, just right here, you know, just going out for a swim. And then bam, we have two people right here just causing the distraction. Is that the same girl from before? Okay, that's not the same girl from before, but it still is super distracting. I mean, this two people right here, it's just way too distracting. It must be super hard for the photographer to get a good shot with all these people around. Oh man. And even right here, they're still there, and it seems like they don't go away. And we have another person right here sticking their legs in. I mean, maybe it was way too expensive to like rent out the pool. Maybe that's why they didn't do it, and they're like, alright, we'll just like live with it. But I feel like it's a little bit distracting, if not a little bit, a lot distracting. But next, we finally don't see people and we see her laying down where the other girl was previously, it looks like. I like this juxtaposition because this is her being cute, you know, smiling, hands like this, not my favorite pose, but it's very cutesy and idly, so that's why they do it. But we have this picture right here, and then we have on this picture right here with her trying to model a little bit more, using a little bit more of the angles in her legs, angles in the arms, angles everywhere, and it's really model-like, and her kind of giving the expression of like, it's way too hot in here, my skin is going to get burned and I'll lose that magazine deal. And then again, we have the cute idol one versus the model one. So I think this is a nice juxtaposition. Although, why this white? I mean, you could extend it out a little bit more, and I mean, you could even take off a little bit more of this. I feel like this isn't really adding anything and it would concentrate more on her. I mean, if you're using a good camera, there's enough DPI in there for the image, or even megapixels if you want to use that. Would you just look at these images? I mean, look at all of this white space. This was like the most unnecessary two pages ever. I don't even know like what you would do with these. Like maybe having this one right here big, or this one right here big, and just cropping it right here, making her the big thing, and then making all of this over here, like the right page, would have been a better decision than what happened over here. And then we move on to this one, like the most blurry picture I've ever seen in a photo book before. This one's like, she took the picture, shutter speed was probably super slow, and then she took it and it came out blurry like this. Although I do like that they included a photo like this in there though. This one's a tad too big for my taste. I feel like her face being 3/4 would have been fine if the little ear over here wasn't too out of it. Because when the ear's over here, it makes it look even bigger. and a little bit more distracting. Then moving to this one. This one's actually fairly nice because this is actually flash photography, because as we see, the sun's in the background, but then there's this nice flash coming in. You can tell by the sharp line right here, because during sunset, the shadows are a little bit more softer, and this sharp line over here means that a flash was introduced into the scene. And plus, another big sign is that the dress is like fully stopped, and that's thanks to flash, because with the flash, you don't need that much shutter speed, because the flash actually captures it, and the shutter speed doesn't really do anything other than letting in more of the ambient light. A little bit technical, but you know. So this is actually very nice. That's the point. Although in this one, this is obvious flash again, because look at the lines over here. It's a little bit softer because the light is closer, but with the light being closer, we have this fall off over here into shadow, which is more obvious that there was a flash. And this is trying to be a little bit more moody. I feel like a sharper light would have helped with this one more. Maybe having the light a little bit more back, having the sharper shadows against her cheekbone and stuff would have worked out better. Next is one of my favorite photos in the photo book. It's this one right here. I feel like it's very expressive. The face she has is solid face, like the best face I've seen Watanabe Rika pull off. And I don't know, it's just very expressive in the eyes, and mouth, and plus the pose that she's holding. And I feel like this ambience really goes with it. So having this, this one isn't really necessary, and plus it's really, really blurry. This one alone would have just been worth it. Then move on to this image right here, which I feel like is a little bit too cutie for its own good. I feel like they could have done something with the arms to make this a little bit more fashionable or a little bit more eye-appealing. And this sweater here blocking off almost everything in the front is really distracting, and the arms being like this makes her arm look bigger than it's supposed to be. And there's a lot of negatives to having it like this, but it is like the very like stereotypical idol pose. So again, maybe she wants a little more cutie idol, but I feel like what she's wearing doesn't really express that. And of course, what would an idol photo book be without brushing of teeth? I actually like the both of them together here. This is one of those 1 second apart, but with the toothbrush being on different sides, I feel like it just adds a little bit more variety in it. And I really like her hair in these pictures. I feel like the straighter bangs actually work out really well for her face, other than like the ones that she usually has. Then we move on to super blurry images where the shutter speed was too low. Although I do like the alcohols over here flying in the background. It looks like someone threw him in there, which is super funny. Next up, I want to talk about this image right here, which I think is really good. I feel like this is like top 5 worthy, but it's way too small and all this white space distracts from it. I feel like if this one was big and then having this one on the side of it, I feel like that would have been a nice juxtaposition with her posing serious and then her laughing, kind of like we did before in the other one where it was her, you know, acting all cutesy and then her acting like a model. I feel like it would have had a nice comparison between the two and a nice contrast. I want to mention real quick, this one is just funny to me because as you can see, she's pointing and getting food, but it doesn't look like her mouth ever moves. Seems like she's just like pointing and like probably like making noises at her. So this one's just funny to see, and it's always good to have these humor ones, more personality ones in this. And we have this series of images with her playing soccer. It's like 6 pages full of her playing soccer with the kids. So I feel like she was there for a long time, and then the photographer's like, all right, we gotta go. She's like, no, I'm gonna keep on playing. So it's a nice little thing there. Although I'm not too sure about the wardrobe. When I was looking at this, I said, oh man, she looks like a JoJo character. If you want to see that, look at the behind the scenes on Patreon. Yeah, she looks like a JoJo character. It's kind of a weird outfit. Next, I move on to my favorite image of the photo book, and it's this one right here. It would have been even better if they, you know, gave her a little bit less headroom. But the reason I like this is because the lighting is nice, because it's a nice like Rembrandt lighting. Like if you see, here's a little triangle of light, so it's very nice in that aspect. Plus, we see a lot of the background kind of giving off the vibe where she's at. So having those two in together, plus the nice bokeh in the background, actually really work out. As you can see, it isn't like full like 1.4 aperture. This is probably like 8 aperture since it's so far in the background. So keeping that in mind, the photographer thought about this and thought, I don't want that totally in blur, so I'll keep the aperture a little bit higher. And we have another one that's similar, but I feel like this stuff on the left is a little bit too distracting, and her being the dividing between it is distracting, as I said before. Talking about this one's like way too deep in the corner. It feels like the image is like this big, and they just blend it into the white just to make it look like it's part of the picture. But really, it just makes her look really small, like, compared to the page and everything else. Next is this one right here. I feel like this wouldn't have been good if this guy wasn't looking as well. I feel like with both of them looking, I feel like there is something on the side, and her looking off in wonderment isn't for nothing. And with him looking, it really adds to this photo. If he wasn't looking, this would look kind of weird with her looking out to the side and everyone else just eating, minding their own business. So props to that guy for doing that. And finally, we move on to this picture, which is my second favorite. This is like a toss-up between the two. I really didn't know, like, it could still change which one is my favorite, but this is the other one that I was deciding between. And I have to say, the posing on this is actually fairly nice. The arms in the air is not too bad because it's her grabbing her bracelet, and I feel like it shows off even more of the body and is able to actually express it where I missed it before in some of the other photos. And this kind of overblown look doesn't really bother me too much. Thanks to her wearing white, it kind of gives off the high-key impression, but there's like dark objects in the back that kind of distract from it, but nonetheless, it is still high-key. And as we know, I do like my high-key images or my very dark-key images. For example, Shinoa Mariko's photo book has a nice example of high-key versus low-key images, like right next to each other. So if you haven't seen that, check it out on my channel. And then finally move on to the last image of the photo book, and it's this one right here. This one's fairly nice, actually. This is a nice finisher to the photo book because it is at the Colosseum. I think it's the Colosseum. And we have her standing right here with the red, kind of causing all the attention to go on her and then making everyone go into the background without it being too much full of bokeh, because we still see some of the details over here. So this is fairly nice, and her being right here smack dab in the middle of this page with everything else over here is actually a very nice touch, which I wish the photographer would have done more in this photo book. Oh, I totally forgot about one picture. It's this one right here, and this is her coming back because as we see, the little Eeyore donkey is here, which she bought in the photo book. So this is just a nice little like fashion one. It isn't like the best or the worst. It's very like, I forgot his name, but this is a style of photography, which I mean, I'm not the biggest fan of, but I can see its purpose. So yeah, this is kind of like a I'm home kind of feeling. It isn't like the best finisher, but I mean, it kind of gives us an impression to help out with maybe this. It's a nice little like side one to include as a bonus, I feel like. More than like a finisher, like this one. This one is a finisher. And then this one's like a little bonus. So yes, that's Watanabe Rika's photo book. That's her first photo book, first Keyakizaka 46 photo book. So what did I think about it? Well, my expectations were all over the place. I had low expectations on her expressions, but I had high expectation on her modeling. I didn't know what to expect from the photographer. The location, I kind of guessed it would be a little touristy. I wouldn't think that they really had the budget to like rent out the place. So in that aspect, I kind of expected it to be a little like this. But overall, I wouldn't say it's a bad photo book. In fact, I would say it's a pretty good photo book, but I wouldn't say it's one of the best ones or like top 10. Again, this feels a little bit more average photo book. I still think Ikuta Erika's is better than this one. And that's totally not biased. Like as a like photography wise, that one is better. Even it has like weird color balance issues. At least the 10 pictures in here that were super blurry aren't in that one. And so far, if I were able to rank them from like all the ones I've done recently, like the recent ones that have come out in November, December, number one was Thubi Shinichi Mai's really good photo book. Number two would probably be Wakatsuki Yumi. Number three, Watanabe Rika. And number four, Hori Miona. Hori Miona, I feel like, will stay in the lower ranking. Watanabe Rika can go up and stay with the top three. So that's future projections for that. I feel like the next person might be lower or higher. Again, it could really go to anything. So who would I recommend this photo book to? I'd recommend it to Watanabe Rika fans, of course, but I'd also recommend it to Keyakizaka fans, as showing this is the first photo book that came out, and it's actually not that bad of a photo book. So if you're interested in this photo book, I recommend picking it up, because looking at it in person is actually 10,000 times better than looking at it online or in this video. If you have the photo book in person, you can actually see the photos that I skipped, a lot of good photos if you're a fan to look at, and again, you can just look through the photo book and see for yourself. So yes, once again, if you're a Keyakizaka fan, recommend picking it up if you're into photo books. Now we just have to wait to see if Neru's is better. I'm trying not to get high hopes for Neru's photo book. I feel like I have a little bit higher hopes than I did for Watanabe Rika, so hopefully that doesn't come and bite me. But there's only one way to find out, and that's when the photo book comes out. Watch my critique and see what I think about it. If you want to see other critiques I've done, you can go ahead and go to the playlist of photo book critiques that I've done. And if you want to see the future ones, you can go ahead and subscribe. You can like this video and leave your comments down below of what you thought of the video or of the photo book if you own it. So hopefully you enjoy this video. And as I say every single time, thank you all for watching.